episode, I'm going to be reading some more short creepy stories for you, so I'll probably read a few depending on how I feel. I'm not feeling too great still, and I've had my first COVID vaccine, so I feel a little bit like I've been hit by a truck, but I'm pushing through for you guys.
Smoke. You found her. Yup. You are
almost had me though. I laugh. All right, my turn. Where did you put her? I gestured to the creek area. Somewhere over there. Drowning's an issue though. Jerk, he says, running off. I smile, watching him go. I love adult hide and seek. What the heck? That's creepy stuff. So like two brothers are playing hide and seek with some girl or something. That's crazy. I bet she's not enjoying hide and seek. I bet she's like, no, I'm done. I would be. That was a good one. I enjoyed that one. What did you guys think to that one? Okay, so we're gonna keep it moving and move on to the next story, which is called The Eyes Are Watching Me. This one sounds creepy, so let's hope it lives up to its name. I bought a new house in the small town of Winthrop. The house was cheap, but the most important part was that I needed to get away from the city. A few months ago, I had a run-in with a stalker. While I had managed to get him arrested, I couldn't shake the feeling of eyes just constantly watching me. I felt like there were eyes everywhere, at home and on the street. So I decided to move out into the country to somewhere with less people, just for peace of mind. The house itself was big and somewhat old, but otherwise very welcoming. The agent who introduced me to the house had even required to mention that a serial killer had lived there in the past, which is why the house was so cheap. However, he and later my next door neighbor Sarah both told me to pay the thought no mind. Four other homeowners had lived in the house since then, and all of them were very happy with it. I love the house. Its interior furnishings were beautiful and very comfortable. The people of Winthrop were very friendly, often bringing over freshly baked pastries or inviting me over for dinner. Get-togethers, they said, were the key to making sure everyone who lived in Winthrop loved it there. Yet after a week, I stopped loving it. The feeling of someone watching returned, worse than before. I tried to ignore it, but soon I started losing sleep. Giant bags grew under my eyes, and I began yawning almost as much as I breathed. Sarah was kind enough to let me stay in her house for a few nights. It was during this time that I heard the legend of the Forest Carter, the serial killer who lived in the house. While no one knows his exact kill count, Carter, also known as the Winthrop Peacock, was a man with extremely severe case of narcissism. Legends say that he couldn't fall asleep if he didn't feel like he was being watched. He was finally arrested for putting up a scarecrow to watch him during the night. Only it wasn't a scarecrow. Carter had murdered a 17-year-old girl just so her cops could stare at him. The story gave me shivers, and after I went home, I felt like there were hundreds of pairs of eyes just watching me, no matter how I turned. Today, however, was the first day that I acted out. I was cooking breakfast when I felt the eyes. Instinctively, out of fear, I threw my kitchen knife, which lodged itself into the wall. As I pulled it out, I found myself staring at a pair of eyes. Picklinin, formalin, hide. I've been watching. The police peel away the drywall of my house for hours now. So far, they found 142 pairs of eyes in glass jars. The scariest thing is, each and every